I thought we played, extremely hard. There was a lot of resiliency in our team. They fight till the end. It was a matter of, once again, kind of the big plays, explosive plays. Defensively, we gave up. Special teams and defense, we gave up, six explosive plays in the first half. And when I say explosive plays, that's a play of 20 yards or more. Obviously, we had the kickoff return to start the game for a touchdown that they got on us, which got to be better. We got to be better on our special teams and particularly kickoff. And then they had a couple big long runs, about 30 yards or so. Then they had the 80-some-yard pass for a touchdown and a 60-yard pass for a touchdown and a 30-yard pass for a touchdown. And, they only threw the ball 9 times but completed 8 of them for big yards. And that was really, I thought, the big story of the game. We didn't execute a few things on offense. I thought offense, we got better. But particularly at the end of the first half, there were a couple of things that – Nate missed a couple throws that could have given us first downs, and instead it gave the ball back to Davidson to allow the 2-minute drive where they got the 30-yard pass. And it's a fine line between winning and losing, and certainly the score of that game, once again, there's a fine line between that score being closer and us having an opportunity. Obviously, Davidson's a very good football team, very physical. They wore on us, and that is something that a team that has a lot of seniors and a team that is established, it has been able to do. And obviously we've got to get, still a lot better, in a lot of different areas if we want to get to where Davidson is. And that's surely a goal of ours. They're the reigning conference champs, and they were kind of where we were not too long ago, and their coaching staff there has done a great job, and everyone at the school has made the commitment to it, and they've done well and won the conference last year, and I see them obviously as the team to beat again this year. So once again, great effort. Got to get better, and we'll continue to work hard to make those strides. Yeah, I thought if we could have made them a little bit more two-dimensional. The one thing about Davidson is, and it held true on Saturday, is they throw the ball when they want to throw the ball, not when they need to throw the ball. And we needed to force them into situations where they threw the ball when they needed to. And if we could have forced that and been a little more, because I thought we held up on the run okay, obviously. We would give up chunks of yards, but then tighten it down. I thought some of that was okay, but I think the big plays in the passing game obviously is what hurt us the most. And it's easy to do. You got to have good eyes, and it takes a mature secondary to be able to play that. It's the first time that we've seen it, we won't see anything like that again this year. Yeah, I do see some similarities. Obviously, they started off with two really tough games against ranked opponents, and as we see, now Austin Peay is ranked as well. So very, very similar competition to start the season. And really, I thought played well in some aspects against Stetson on Saturday, but they turned the ball over 4 times. They threw a pick 6. They had a couple block punts, so they kind of gave up the big play as well. So I see a lot of similarities. Obviously, it's going to be tough to go to their place and get a win. We have to play really well, but obviously they're hungry, and I'm sure their coaches are on them about it's the little things that matter, and it is a fine line between winning and losing, and it was a fine line for them as well as they played Stetson this past weekend and gave up some plays where if they shore up some of those things, they're right there in the game with the chance to win. Well, we hope so. You know, we hope so. They give us a lot of different looks in the secondary, and we'll have to be really good and disciplined. You know, have to be smart with the football. They'll trick you a few times in coverage wise. So we definitely have to be smart at the quarterback position and get to the right spot and take what the defense gives us. But you know, there's no doubt that we need to get Dell and the run game going. It's an emphasis. It's an emphasis to get Dell more carries, get more balls his way, and we knew that it was going to be a kind of a heavy passing game this past week. And I know I constantly say that we need to get the running game going, and we haven't quite got it going the way. We haven't ran the ball bad. We just haven't ran the ball effective like I would like to, you know, and get us into some situations and some third down situations where they're very manageable run game type of situations. And we haven't been able to do that as well as I'd like so far. But it is an emphasis. And I don't know how many big plays we have in a passing game. I think they're decent. They have given up a lot of passing yards, but you got to look at who they've played as well. And sometimes they're in the right spot. They just don't make the play on the ball. Well, we always try to spread the ball around. I think Kibby has obviously been a very good player for us, and he's kind of been that deep threat. And you know, there's always plays in the playbook that can get the ball down the field and stretch the field vertically. And Kibby's been one of those guys. You know, he's one of our, you know, faster guys that can get down the field. And certainly Nate has a strong arm and can get it to him. And we have, you know, schemed up a few things there for Kibby to try to get him deep. But there's always things like that in your pass game. We do spread the ball around a little bit, with our wide receivers. But Kibby has seemed to play or have the big play type of potential. But I think all of our guys, I think Sean Lodge has that potential. You know, of course, Jalen Jones has that potential. It's just a matter of, you know, kind of who's in that spot that the defense is kind of letting get over the top in a one-on-one situation. And this week that they don't give a lot of, kind of one-on-one over the top situations. So, you know, we'll see. Like I said, we'll have to, you know, take what the defense gives us, it'll be a lot different than this past weekend. This past weekend was a lot of man coverage and cover three. So we kind of knew the coverages we were getting. And this week is quite a bit different, the way they play coverage. And so may have to go into some different types of looks and get to our second and third read several times this week.